how many ways can you join your data without using traditional SQL joins? As SurrealDB is a multimodal database, it has different ways of joining data together. In this video, we'll cover the graph model. SurrealDB introduces a relate statement to SQL for making graph relationships. A short introduction to working with graph data is that you have nodes connected by edges. Here, we can see that person is a node, order is an edge, and product is also a node. Another way to think about it is in terms of nouns connected by verbs, such that it forms a sentence. In our example, person, order, product. Most graph databases work with these semantic triples. What sets SurrealDB apart from graph-only databases, however, is that our edges are also real tables, such that you can store information in them, which allows for even more flexible data models. In this instance, order is actually an order items table, which has its own information along with the information joined from the person and product table. Because we have specified the relationship in the relate statement, it becomes easy and efficient to fetch the required fields from the joined tables. As you can see, when we start getting the fields from the product table, the arrow syntax differentiates this from the record links we saw in a previous video. Aside from starting with the arrow syntax, you would use a dot and bracket syntax in exactly the same way as a record links or embedded objects. Notice that the direction of the arrow changes whether we are fetching from the product or person table. Looking at the relate statement again, we can see that we only specified one direction, going from person to order to product. SurrealDB, however, has bidirectional querying by default that therefore enables us to specify it once but use it in both directions. When we now select star from order, we can see that the record we just created in the order edge table. I want to bring your attention to three specific fields. Those are ID, in, and out. Now, you might be wondering, when were these fields created, since it didn't seem like we specified them before? Well, we did specify the in and out field with a relate statement, and because we didn't specify the order ID, it was generated for us. Another way of looking at the relate statement is that the first node is called in, the edge is the ID, and the second node is the out. Now I want to bring your attention to the second select statement, which shows how you can select the same field using the arrow syntax. Both of these statements are valid ways of querying the data. Graph relations can be both super powerful and elegant once you get more comfortable using them. In this example, we are creating a simple recommendation system in just one query. What this is saying is, based on all the product this person purchased, which person also purchased those products, and what did they purchase? Aside from being a tongue twister, this is a really powerful way of expressing logic. And if we were to express it using SQL joins, we would need up to six of them, as we're joining three tables at different levels of granularity, and then a where clause to filter on a specific person. When doing multiple joins like this, you really start to see the advantages of the graph model. There are, however, trade-offs to each approach, and a trade-off we are making here is establishing the relationships at write time to make it simpler and easier for everyone at query time. However, what if we wanted to make arbitrary relationships on the fly? We will cover that in the following video, talking more about relational style joins. That's all we have for you today. If you like this kind of content, make sure to like and subscribe, and tell us what you want to see next in the comments below.